Greetings, folks. It's Skiz Fernando welcoming you back to another edition of Pan Asian. And in my quest to find a healthy, quick, and easy Asian meal for you to make in your very own kitchen, I stumbled across this recipe for Lao curry chicken, which is a great dish. It's basically a one-pot meal, meaning you've got everything, meat, vegetables, chilies, starch thrown into one pot. You cook it up and you serve it over rice, and got yourself a quick and tasty meal. And I'm going to show you how to make that right now, so follow me. To make this dish, you will need 2 cups of coconut milk, 1/4 cup of yellow curry paste, and as you can see here, I'm using a store-bought variety. This brand is actually very good. It's called Mesri. It's a Thai brand, and it's going to save you a lot of time. Of course, if you want to make your own curry paste, check out the recipe on my blog. 1 large onion chopped, 2 cloves of garlic minced. I've got 2 pounds of chicken thighs with the bone in, cleaned and cut into nice chunks. 5 to 6 fresh red or green chilies sliced diagonally into 2-inch segments. 1 stalk of lemongrass sliced diagonally into 2-inch segments. 3 medium potatoes cubed. 1/2 pound of long beans or green beans sliced diagonally into 2-inch segments. And finally, 1.5 tablespoons of fish sauce. We start off with a hot wok, and you know your wok is hot when it starts smoking like that. So the first thing we're going to do is add 1 cup of the coconut milk. And we're just going to slowly bring that to a boil and add about 1/4 cup of our yellow curry paste, which is about 1/2 of the can. Okay, next we're going to add the onions. Incorporate that into the mix, and we're going to cook it for about 5 minutes more. And I've got the heat at about medium low right now. All right, so I'm just going to leave that for about 10 minutes. Okay, this has been cooking now for 10 minutes, and it's time to add the chilies and the lemongrass. And
we're just going to incorporate these two big flavor boosters into the mix. The recipe says you can add some salt, but I'm actually going to hold off for now because I know the curry paste was very salty. And the last dish I made, I put a little bit too much salt in it. So I'm going to use my salt sparingly this time. Left. And be sure to incorporate that as well. So it's been about 10 minutes, so let's see where we are with this. And wow, this is smelling tremendous. It's looking pretty good. And we are still not done because we have to add potatoes and the green beans. And once we incorporate these two ingredients into the mix, we're going to cook it for 10 more minutes uncovered until the potatoes and the beans get tender. You might want to just test and see if the beans and potatoes are done. And the last thing you want to do before serving is to hit it with the fish sauce. Add a little more flavor to it right at the end there. And that fish sauce is pretty strong, so make sure you incorporate it well. And there you have it, folks. This is Lao curry chicken on Pan Asian. And here it is. Check it out. And it's funny, someone asked me if I ever fake my reactions any of the dishes that I make here on Pan Asian. And all I have to say is, I couldn't do that to you guys. As you know, a lot of these dishes I make for the first time right here on the show. So sometimes if the salt is a little off or the chili, you know, I can't control it, but I let you know about it. And right now I'm gonna let you know how the Lao curry chicken tastes. That's pretty good. And I say pretty good considering I used that store-bought curry paste, which was a Thai brand called Mesri. It was the yellow curry paste. There's actually also a recipe for yellow curry paste on my blog at riceandcurry.com. If you check the recipe and if you want to actually make the curry paste, you can do that. But let me tell you, this store-bought curry paste is pretty good. I would definitely use it again. So here's to you. Here's to the Lao Curry Chicken. My name is Skiz Fernando, and I'll see you next time on Pan Asian.